In a scene from the famous animated movie Wall-E, a rocket is launched from Earth to reach the skies. It pierces through a thick layer of old satellites and artificial objects before reaching outer space. The protagonist in this movie, a tiny robot, is clinging to the rocket and gets caught in a recognizable satellite, Sputnik 1, the very first satellite ever launched into Earth's orbit, now reduced to a mere piece of trash. This scene carries an important message that may even become our reality one day. Millions of these man-made objects are zipping around our planet right now, from dead satellites to hardware nuts and flecks of paint. But what happens to this space trash? What risks does it pose to future space explorations? And are we doing anything about it? First, let's establish what space trash is. The trash or junk in space is commonly known as space debris. We'll be using that term in this video. And it refers to all the debris that is generally around the Earth's orbit. The debris consists of all the human-made objects that no longer serve a function. This includes spacecrafts, launch stages of rockets, waste from the rockets, and the fragmentation of these objects. A lot of debris come from explosions of objects. Parts of rockets that end up in orbit are a significant source of the debris. Much of this is in low Earth orbit. Over 10,000 metric tons of debris is estimated to be floating around the Earth's orbit. For comparison, this weighs as much as the Eiffel Tower. As of November 2022, NASA reported more than 25,000 artificial objects in Earth's orbit. Many of these artificial objects are satellites that are used in many important areas and disciplines of meteorology, telecommunication, navigation, and space exploration. In a report recently, there are 5,465 active satellites orbiting Earth. Satellites, however, can't live forever. Usually, when they run out of fuel or malfunction, they become giant pieces of trash floating around the Earth. The first piece of human-made satellite, Sputnik 1, resulted in the creation of the very first debris and called a need for the surveillance of these objects. Radar and optical detectors such as LiDAR are currently the primary tools for tracking space debris. There are an estimated 36,500 objects greater than 10 cm, 1 million objects between 1 to 10 cm, and 130 million objects between 1 mm to 1 cm. Some of the debris in space includes unique items like a glove, a camera, a wrench, and even a toothbrush. But what happens to this debris? Objects usually remain in orbit for a few years until they re-enter the Earth's atmosphere. Most burn up in the atmosphere, however larger objects can reach the ground. In fact, it has and still does. An average of one piece of debris has fallen back to Earth each day for the past 60 years. Much of it falls in the ocean, but there have been reports of numerous smaller debris found on land. Luckily, the chances of a debris hitting anyone is incredibly slim, as there has only been one reported case of such a debris hitting a person. Some of the space debris is also from the results of collisions. For instance, when two satellites collide, they can smash into thousands of smaller broken pieces, creating more debris. This is a big problem, and it has been theorized that Earth's orbit could even become impassable if the risk of collision grows too high. Satellites must actively maneuver to avoid incoming space debris and prevent potential damage or destruction. February 10, 2009 marked the first instance of a satellite collision, when the active Iridium 33 satellite, moving at a speed of 11.7 kilometers per second, accidentally collided with the Russian military satellite Cosmos 2251. Both satellites were destroyed, resulting in thousands of pieces of new, smaller debris, with legal and political liability issues unresolved even years later. Although not all collisions in space are accidental, some result from specific military exercises and tests called anti-satellite tests. Countries like China, India, US and Russia have successfully launched missiles to shoot down their satellites. Unfortunately, these actions have resulted in creating more debris. The US became the first nation to ban these anti-satellite weapon tests, but experts say it will take much more to ensure a sustainable space environment. Before all of this, an intriguing theory was proposed by NASA scientist Donald Kessler in 1978, which became known as the Kessler Syndrome, and stated that an excessive amount of debris in Earth's orbit one day could trigger a chain reaction of collisions, resulting in more debris and subsequent collisions. For the future of successful space exploration and satellite launches, it is crucial that the orbit remains clutter-free and the debris does not trigger Kessler syndrome. So what about cleaning up the orbit as a solution? How can we remove the debris that is already up there? For some time now, several space programs and missions have been working on methods of actively removing space debris, namely clean space, remove debris, Android, and e-deorbit. In 2018, Remove Debris, for instance, practiced a mission of grabbing defunct satellite using a giant net. There are other methods for removing debris as well, but these methods are conceptual or at an experimental phase and require much more study before it can be established as a viable option. In recent years, the activity of commercial space and satellite programs has surpassed that of government and military programs. For instance, Starlink currently has over 3,500 small satellites orbiting the Earth. In addition to Starlink, Kuiper Systems, OneWeb, and many others have plans to deploy thousands more satellites into the orbit. There is also a regulatory problem. Currently, there are no internationally agreed upon rules regarding space debris. No one is bound to limit the number of satellites they can launch into the orbit or take responsibility for the debris they create. So what does that leave us for the future? With over 100 satellite launches each year, with the number expected to increase in the coming years, we wonder what impact this will have on the already crowded space environment. As a consequence of the rising space debris, the probability of catastrophic collisions can grow exponentially. Earth's orbit is a precious resource that has allowed us to unlock incredible technological advances and discoveries. As we continue to expand our use of space, we must do so in a way that is responsible and sustainable, so that future generations can also reap its benefits. Achieving this goal will require a collective effort from governments, the private sectors, and the international community that prioritize the long-term health of the space that is above us. If you would like to see more of this, be sure to check out our previous videos and remember to subscribe. Hit the bell icon to stay notified of upcoming videos. If you have some future video suggestions, comment down below.